you blessed? I just want you to say amen.
Yes.
And I said I was going to try my musicians, because I was talking about the book of Psalms of 50, when David says that you have to praise God with all the instruments. And so I'm going to get my instrumentalist to do something they've never done before. They haven't rehearsed for this. So if I pray for you, I just want you to do something crazy with whatever you have for the next 5 seconds. Is that okay? Is that okay?
I'm
night, but you've never been able to. This is the best night to do it, okay? So lean forward, lean backwards, to the left, to the right. Now stand up, sit down, to the left, to the right. Lean forward, lean backwards, to the left, to the right. Stand up, sit down, to the left, to the right. Lean forward, lean backward, to the left, to the repeat after me. Lean forward, lean backward.
To the left, yes, to the left, yeah. To the right, yes. Stand up, yes. Sit down, okay, okay.
I'm gaping hole with everything else except Jesus. Even the forbidden fruit. Thirsty, boys and girls. Don't you know that your thirst can only be truly quenched at the Saviour's roots? So I'm here to call back all the sojourners. I'm calling polar opposites. When your situation and the world tells you that he doesn't exist, look around you. Creation and your spirit will testify to the opposite. And he's so great that I know that there will never be another moment like this. So if there is ever a time that we or you and I should say a public thank you, I think this is it. Like, I want to say thank you for granting our eyes the privilege of seeing the way that they majestically glide through the air. Like, thank you for giving us goosebumps that rise slow and steady like the sun when it encounters the winter's air. You see, I want to thank you for giving me this heart that beats like a drum and dances at the sound of your name and sometimes fear. You see, I want to thank you for granting these eyes the privilege of seeing a murmuration of your blessings in my life. Forgive us for those days when we haven't publicly testified but have kept them in cages. You see, I guess that's just our greedy and covetous way of saying you've given us beauty and victory, and like any covetous child, we just want to claim it. But we can only imagine what it would be like if we weren't able to see his marvel or experience his wonders, like the things in the night, like the stars and the skies, the patterns of the Milky Way, or hear the crashings of the oceans, or see the different colours of the seas, like the blue waters of Bora Bora or the green tides of Maldives. Different hues of our eyes. Can you imagine not being able to see the love dance of flamingos, a forest filled with autumn trees, or the beauty of a snowfall, or how a school of thousands of dolphins go swimming peacefully underneath an ever-shifting sea? You see, I guess if we couldn't see, then none of these things probably wouldn't matter. But he would probably be just as awesome and be just as vibrant. The buffaloes would still go charging across the African savannah, and your favorite colors would dance in front of your face, but you don't have eyes to experience his laughter. And the grass would be greener on the other side behind that white picket fence. In fact, the fence probably wouldn't be there. The grass wouldn't be there at all, and plants wouldn't come from seeds. Now imagine with me, because since we walk by faith and can't see the beautiful and awesome and powerful being that created all of these, also created you and me. I see a shepherd singing from his rooftop the words of Psalm 18. His ways are perfect. There were no mistakes, no imperfection. Your body, this soul, was never meant to be an imperfect reflection. So I don't blame you for those days when you don't quite fit in. This body, your soul, was not put together with chameleon skin, but you are the creation of a peculiar king who has taken the time out to number the hairs on your head, open your eyes so that you can see, and then even created a song for you to sing. You see, there's nothing else that can take his place. Not one living thing. You see, there's no one that loves you or knows you to come after. He knows your mind, body, soul, laughter. You see, this thought alone should fill your stomach with joy. Have you do the dab like a modern day David? Because you weren't created like robots or toys. Imagine if the skies cursed the ground, or the ground like a man with ropes constantly tried to pull the skies down because they were made of different stuff. We are made physical, yet still he holds the universe together with love. You see, I've never heard the night curse the day because they operated in a different way. But what we do know, what you and I do know, is that the sun lends the moon its light, the skies lends the ocean its reflection, your left feet rely on your right, and even your marvelous eyes rely on your brain to complete his sight. And after we had sinned, he didn't have to make his body the bridge to eternal life. And he said, that's all right, that's okay. Because great is my faithfulness, and my greatness is so great that it never repeats itself in the same way. You see, in him, we are made more beautiful and wonderful with each passing day, glowing and shining in such a marvelous way. You see, he's created us with common senses, so we can all relate. Then individual senses, to taste the sweetness of honey. We are fit spirits, yet he's given us physical body, made us out of clay. Yet still when it rained, we aren't washed away like wet and muddy. So to all my broken masterpieces, trying to fill that gaping hole with everything else except from Jesus, thirsty boys and girls, don't you know that Jesus thirsted on the cross so we don't have to? So this is not for the forbidden fruit, but Jesus thirsted on the cross, so now you don't have to.
is that one of the absolute moves or what is it?
This building, let's lift our hands in the presence of the Lord. We're going to worship Him. The Bible declares that we are to worship Him in the beauty of holiness. I want every hand lifted. If you want to close your eyes, go ahead and close them, but I want you to focus upon Jesus now. For He alone is worthy to be worshipped. And worthy to the Lord. Can I get an amen on that? Can I get an amen on that? The Bible records in Matthew chapter 2 and verse number 11. It says, when the wise men came to the place where baby Jesus was, it says, when they saw Him, they fell down and worshipped Him. Everybody say, fell down. They bowed down and they worshipped Him. And the scripture says, and then their treasures were opened. And they presented unto Him gifts. And there is a glorious revelation of the Spirit. And it is this, that when you and I will humble ourselves and begin to worship, the treasure that is in this earthen vessel begins to open up. Somebody say yes. And the gifts of the Spirit of God that are within us begin to flow. I believe if we will worship God with our whole heart, our whole spirit and soul, God's presence and power will begin to move in this place. People can be healed and delivered even while we're worshiping and recording. Does anybody believe that with me? I want you to lift up your hands now. Begin to lift up your voice. That right. Just begin to open your own mouth and begin to worship Him. Out of your spirit, just begin to bless His holy name. If He's done anything for you, just begin to worship. Just begin to worship. Next time, begin to worship.
I'm going to tell you the story of how and why we are celebrating 10 years of House of Praise. In just less than a minute, Dr. Rick, tell us, 10 years of House of Praise, did you ever see this was going to happen? And just tell us your experience.
About 11 years ago, Nana said to me, I've got this idea for a House of Praise. And he had a vision in his mind of what House of Praise was going to look like. And so we talked and we worked together to introduce the House of Praise. And the House of Praise was not a concert. It wasn't about entertainment. It was about putting God in the center and at the forefront of a worship experience. And I didn't think that it would last for 10 years. And I know that over the years, it's developed, it's changed in some ways, but what we wanted to do for the 10th anniversary is to bring it back to the heart of worship, to bring it back to that focus on God and who God is, and worshiping God, and giving thanksgiving, and giving praise. And that's what House of Praise is all about.
And the 10th night of House of Praise, God bless Steve Griffiths.
Praise has still continued to grow and to build. I remember the very first House of Praise where we had different items from all over Berkshire, and it would be good to see those different items again, which involve children as well as the teens and the adults. So I'm hoping that we will do that in the future, because it's good to see the children taking part in the mime. Wasn't the mime very good? It was absolutely fantastic. Some of those children weren't even born 10 years ago, but look at them. And they're giving praises. We want to thank God that He's taken you through 10 years, and we're looking forward to many more years of House of Praise, when you're going to be doing a lot more things and a lot more things different.
Thank you. Just one more question before we go to Dr. Remy only. Dr. Remy. Now, Dr. Remy, just tell us, because people don't know some of the challenges that goes through in this plan, and I'm sure there's one that can come to mind. Can you think of any major challenge we've had at House of Praise organization?
I can't remember how long ago it was, but it was the idea of charging people to come into House of Praise as a way of, you know, making money. And I know that I got very upset about that, because when we come to worship God, it's free. We shouldn't have to pay to worship or praise God. So I know that a couple of years it was a bit challenging, because so many people were coming, great opportunity to raise funds, but actually if we're coming to worship God, God does not charge us to worship Him. You can charge for entertainment, you can charge to hear a fantastic band, but when you come into an auditorium, a sanctuary to worship God, it's about bringing your heart, it's about worshiping Him, it's about serving Him, it's about adoration, it's about praise. And that's that I think that was one year when... Yeah.
Thank you, we have a round of applause for Dr. Remy. Thank you very much. So there we